Steve Walker here, founder of Ahoy-Boats, where I help people who are interested in sailing trimarans to understand them better so that they can make the right choice when they come to buy one from me. This is an Astus 20.2 Sport, and it's available now. We have fantastic weather. You should be out sailing in one, and if you can't afford this one, then behind it I have an Astus 18.2 Sport, which is about two-thirds of the price. And they're both about a year old, so they're in perfect condition and available at a good price. Both of them have got the essential options, the essential extras. The gennaker, for when the wind is light, which is mounted on a furler on the bowsprit. The swim ladder, for getting back into the boat if you go for a swim, or if you fall overboard, and it's also handy for getting in and out of the boat when the boat's on the trailer. The trailer, very important. These boats are trailer sailors, and I've made another video about the value of trailer sailing and what a great thing it is to be able to do. So you can have a look at that. The trailers are French. French isn't always the same standard as things that you can get in the UK or elsewhere. And so it's important to have a spare wheel. And these come with a spare wheel. I like to supply boats with an extra reef in the mainsail because the UK is one of the windiest countries, if not the windiest country in Europe. And it's cooler, and the wind is therefore denser and heavier and has a greater power to knock the boat over. So to have a second reef, as opposed to just one reef, is an important thing to have in reserve. And of course you can even take the sails down, sail with just the mast or just the jib. So these boats will cope with a lot of weather. Both boats have a mounting for an outboard motor. Now this boat has never had an outboard motor. It's been kept on a lake, and on that particular lake they don't allow engines. So this boat's never been used with an engine. But if you're going to go on the sea, you need to have an engine. It's the iron sail, the spare sail, if you like. Your sails are your spare engine, and your engine is your spare sail. The Astus 20.2, I always have an engine for this sort of size of boat. I quite often will sail on the sea. And having said that, although the engine's a year old, it's not even run in yet, because you only need a puff of wind and these boats will be sailing. So you only really need them for getting away from the shore or out of a harbour or manoeuvring around, and the rest of the time they're idle, unless you happen to be unlucky enough to find yourself with no wind and needing to get back to wherever you started or wherever you're trying to get to next. And quite a lot of harbours will only allow you to go in and out of them under engine power and not sail power. That particular engine has a high thrust prop, because these are only lightweight boats. And if you have a normal prop, the engine will be buzzing along at a very high rate and not able to push the boat as fast as it could push it for only a 5 horsepower. With the 5 horsepower engine, you can get 7.5 knots with the 20.2 and probably go faster again with the 18.2, which is lighter. The 20.2 has Dacron sails, whereas this boat, the 18.2S, that has the more sporty Pentex or Mylar sails, which look very swish, and you have to look after them, but they will make the boat go a little bit faster. And if you're racing, this is the sort of sail that you would want to have. So the 20.2 has a cabin. Lock it up. Obviously, access to it is a lot easier when you haven't got the mast down like this, which of course you wouldn't have if you were sailing, it would be mounted here. The 20.2S also has a mattress and bunk plank. That that's the centerboard in the middle there, and that is the bunk plank hiding underneath. This bit of the mattress is removable, and that is the rudder up there. So you can either sit in the boat. As you can see, I'm sitting quite comfortably inside the cabin without the bunk plank.
I haven't got a wide enough angle lens.
Maybe over there you can see a bit better. All down there. Or you can put the bunk plank in place and you have a bunk which will accommodate two people. And I've had good holidays in this boat, and you could too. I mean, look at the weather that we're having. Fantastic weather we're having. And you need to have a boat. If you haven't got one, now's the time to buy one of these two boats. And if you can't afford one of these, I've got a Magnum 21, which started all this off lying in Scotland. And if you can't afford one of those, then there's a small Virus Plus, which is in the Low Countries. I can't remember if it's Belgium or Holland, which is also available. And that would be a great starter boat for somebody if you want to get into trimarans. So the 20.2 also has the spare wheel, the mast support bar for supporting the mast whilst you're driving along, and the mast stepping bar for lifting the mast into place, which is an absolute boon, and I would certainly recommend anybody buying one of these new to have that. It also has an anchor kit and a compass. And lots of space underneath for storing bits and pieces. That's a pump I keep in there, hand pump. And that PVC thing is my little dinghy, which cost all of £10 in Clandidno. A little cubby hole for the fuel tank. And the one on the other side is where I usually keep my flares. And by that I don't mean trousers. I mean emergency rockets and things like that. The Astus 18.2, on the other hand, doesn't have a cabin, but it does have a locker. And in this locker, you can store all sorts of useful things. Like the rudder, as in the other boat. The centreboard is here. And there's a boat hook. Of course, these boats are at their trailing width at the moment, so we only have to do that. And same at the other end. Stand somewhere about the middle and pull. I can transform it into its floating trimaran, full sailing width in a jiffy. And that can be done on the water, standing in the boat. You can expand it and contract it, and that's very useful sometimes if you're coming into a marina and you need to get into a narrow berth or something like that. This is the engine mounting for the 18.2S, and this is a sail cover for the jib, which is a great boon if you have the intention of keeping your boat on a mooring, because it saves you taking the jib on and off every time you use the boat. You just slip this over it to stop the sun getting at it. And that's worth about €300. So what about values? Well, if you wanted to buy this 18.2S now, today, new, it would cost you about £18,400. That's including VAT and X, that would be X Chester. If you wanted to buy the Astus 20.2S today, that would cost you almost £27,000 new. But they're a year old, and although they're in pristine condition, a year old boat is a year old boat, and so the Astus 20.2S is available for just below 23,997, and this boat 16,500.